What is up, everyone? Welcome to my next LP, Capcom and Nintendo. Oh god, who didn't see this one coming? Oh boy! Yeah, it's the Minish Cap. And this came out in 2005. I was completely wrong when I was talking out the ass in Mega Man five, which I don't want to talk about, because I was supposed to be a lot better at that game than I ended up being. So look, we have files. This is some crazy shit, right? I'm gonna take the top file, and away we go. We're gonna be Foppy, because that's the best enemy in Earthbound. It's hilarious. Don't touch the gamepad. Did you fucking touch it? And look, I'm hatless. Hatless. I have options. Message speed. What? Oh man, I wanted to choose message speed. This is starting off really well. Let's see what we got. Long, long time ago, when the world was on the verge of being swallowed by shadow, a new Star Fox led by the son of James McCloud, the tiny Picory, appeared from the sky, bringing the hero of men a sword and a golden light. Don't just change it, damn. With wisdom and courage, the hero drove out the darkness. This is my serious voice. Look at them, worshipping this. When peace had been restored, the people enshrined that blade with care. And a new Star Fox team was born. Star Fox on the mind. Game comes out soon. It's gonna be hype! What's going on here? We got wood. Apparently Princess Zelda's just allowed to just walk around wherever the hell she damn well pleases. Which is cool. You want that for your princess. Okay, and she could just barge into people's houses, even better. See what's going on here. Good morning, Master Smith! Yeah. You know you're cool when your name has Master in it. Goodness me, Princess Zelda! Did you sneak out of the castle and come all this way alone? The minister is sure to be worried about you. You know how he gets. I'm about to do some crazy fucking Chrono Trigger shit up in here. Oh, don't worry about him. He'll be fine. Where's Foppy? The whole town is bustling for the annual Picory Festival. I thought he and I might go together. Would you mind terribly letting your servants accompany me?
Oh, is that what you're here for? Well, Foppy was up late helping me last night, and he's still asleep because he's really lazy. But I do have an errand at the castle. Yes, that should be fun, yes. Foppy, time to get up and interrupt my cackling.
I don't know why I'm making him out to be so evil. Look at me sleeping. I don't want to get up. I'm a Toys R Us kid. Alright, no, I don't even get an option. Look at this shit. What the fuck did I just do? Okay, yeah. Forgot I switched my buttons around. Look at this. Look at me rolling. This is what I'm gonna do with the rest of my life. I'll just roll. Roll into a peaceful existence. The problems of Hyrule and this little, like, pinwheel piece of hair in the back of my head is, I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Let's check out what the princess want. This is some sweet music. Hello. What you want, girl?
Hey, Foppy. Princess Zelda is here. She'd like to know if you join her at the festival.
Yeah, Foppy, come on. Let's go and check out the festival together, goddammit. Master Smith already gave me permission to take you because apparently you're property.
Yes, after all, the festival only comes once a year. Go on, have fun.
And while you're there, you could do me a favor.
I just finished making the sword for the minister at Hyrule Castle. Yes, the sword!
I'd like you to deliver it to him. Yeah, I accepted the Smith sword. Make sure you don't lose this extremely important delivery. I did the same shit in Twilight Princess, didn't I? This is the blade that will be presented to the winner of the competition. What competition? Don't lose it. And while the two of you may be childhood friends, remember, Zelda's the princess of Hyrule. You watch over her. Don't let anything bad happen to her. Master Smith, quit worrying. You stop that shit right now, Master Smith. And no more cackling for you for unknown reasons. We're gonna go check out the festival like a couple of cool kids. But I see a treasure. I got 20 rupees. That's great. That's so good. Fuck your building, Mr. Smith. He rolls funny. He rolls with such purpose. Foppy over here. All right, let's go. Go, Link. Foppy, whatever the hell your name is. Hello. Let's go. All right. None will contend with the speed of my rolling with my pinwheel head. I think that's called a pinwheel. You know the thing that like spins around in the wind and it's like for kids? Did that make any sense to anybody? Yeah, okay. Wow, mad people in this town got big ass heads and tiny ass necks. Here we are. Doesn't it look fun? Come on, let's look around. Yeah, let's look around. Because we'll be coming back here a lot throughout this game. Let's talk to this guy. So, welcome to the Picory Festival. They say that every 100 years the Picory come to Hyrule. Well, this is the 100th year to the day since the last time the Picory were here. Well, that's amazing. We're going to meet ourselves some Picory. I could just roll around in excitement for that. This is Hyrule Town, in case you didn't know it. Can I change the options? Just out of curiosity? No? Was it just pieces of heart? And I have the Smith's Blade. I say that with such purpose. Hello, lady. Phew! Preparing for the festival left me absolutely exhausted. Still, I'm just enjoying watching people have fun. You're damn right you are. Hello. Okay. Hello. Damn it. Hello. One come all, try your luck and win incredible prizes. Hello, old man.
Long, long ago, and then even longer before that, evil creatures appeared in the world of humans. They were powerful, frightening beasts, and they created such trouble. But then the Picory came from the sky, bringing humans powerful magic. With the magic light force and the Picory Blade, the beasts were repelled, and the world of humans once more knew peace, thanks to the Picory. So as to not forget our gratitude, we hold this festival each year. Now remember, little ones, the Picory only appear before good little children. If you only do bad deeds, you will never get to see them, so be good, and stop throwing eggs at my house!
Oh my god, doing that voice killed my throat. I don't know when they'll bring happiness to you, lady, but you seem to be pretty happy with this goofy-ass ghost on your roof. Hello. Am I enjoying myself?
Eh, I'm okay, you know. Pretty good, I guess. I don't entirely know what I should be doing. I should stop fucking around. That's what I should be doing, but
I never take the time. I know damn well when I was a kid, I never really took the time to really talk to townspeople, and I'm trying to change that. But I don't know what he's talking about. Watching all those sword fights made me hungry. That's cool. Hello. Come on up. Come on up. Come one, come all. Gather around and have a look-see. I'm having a huge sale on all manner of delicious and festive vegetables. Day and night, he's going on about Picory this and Picory that. Doesn't need to learn nothing but a silly fairy tale to make kids behave. Oh, she just like fucking let the cat out of the bag. Hello, airplane. Thank you for joining us this fine evening. You asshole. New York sucks. Hello, old lady. No, I'm not doing that. Sword fighting. I'm probably, like, really good at it. Because I'm the... entirely in black. Oh, boy.
That's ominous. Hello, beetle. Yep. You and your fresh fruits. I'm happy for you, man.
I love festivals! It's like seeing your town transform to another world.
It really gives you a chance to think about how well we have it here. Yeah, if only this airplane wasn't flying by. You're the boy from the old Master Smith's place, right? I'm sure you know this, but he's the best swordsmith Hyrule's ever seen. Every year I enter the tournament trying to win that damn sword of his. Haven't won yet, and maybe I never will, but the tournament was amazing! The winner this year was a new face. I've been wondering where he's from. He's from hell. He used some incredible techniques and won the whole tourney in record time. That's cool. How's it going? I've been on the road for a while. I came back in time for the festival. Feels wonderful. Oh my god, I really need to fucking speed up this sex. It's gonna drive me nuts. I must put these feelings into verse. Okay. Did I talk to you? Yeah, I'm not doing the old man voice for him. So how's everybody doing today? Today is March 13th. Which means it's been well over a month since I finished Mega Man 5. Or has it? Because that had been recorded for a while, and I just took forever to upload it. And then I uploaded it in mad, stupid order. I don't know what the hell was going on. Then I got sick, and then I started grad school. Sort of. It's an interesting situation. I mean, I've never seen the Pickery before. Okay. Hey, guy. Have you ever seen the Pickery? I saw one just the other day. It wore a red cone-shaped hat, and it was really small. You're also describing a garden gnome, so be careful how you're describing your Pickery, kid. It was standing inside my dad's shoe. Okay, no longer is it a garden gnome. That would have been information to have had like 3 seconds ago. So did I talk to everyone? Is that why they're blocking me? Because I haven't spoken to- Oh, there's Zelda! Holy shit, I walked right by Zelda while in the middle of my old man speech. I don't believe in the Pickery. I'm not a kid anymore. I'm too old to believe in any stupid old fairy tales. We'll start drinking coffee, you fucking person. I think I'll really see the Pickery if I'm on my best behavior all the time? No, you have to be cool like me. What's up, girl? Poppy, there's a storyteller here we should stop and listen to. Oh, I wonder what's over there! Oh, there she goes. Oh, that princess. She can never sit still. So the Pickery are real. My father always told me they were. Oh, look at that. Say, wasn't there going to be a sword-fighting tournament at the castle? I wonder who won this year. Oh wow, over here! Aw, Zelda, you're adorable. Whoa, what the hell's going on here? We have a winner. Princess Zelda, you won the grand prize in our drawing, wow! You get your choice of any of these wonderful prizes, what'll it be? What? You better give me that heart-shaped stone! You better pick the heart-shaped stone. You better pick the heart-shaped stone. Zelda, for the love of God, pick the heart-shaped stone. Pick the heart-shaped stone. Pick the stone. That is a piece of heart, right? I mean, it's fucking shining and everything. That should be pick the stone. No! No, that is no! 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 Oh, God. Yeah, why would you want that? Give me the freaking heartstone thing! It's a piece of heart! It's infinitely more useful! If I have more hearts, I don't necessarily need the shield, because I will have more health. Ha ha! With his giant gem, it's pretty. Honestly, they're both much nicer than that nasty little shield thing. She calls it a thing. Nope, I want the shield! Can I have it? Oh, Princess Zelda, woman of the people, she is. What a strange princess you are. Here's your teeny tiny shield. Don't come over to me with that shit. I wanted the piece of heart. I wanna, yeah, of course you did. Of course. Ah, Zelda, what are we gonna do with you? It is a little embarrassing, though it's so tiny. He has to hunch behind the shield. It's not like Dark, well, it is like Dark Souls. Unless you have like those giant fucking, what are they called, Great Shields? And you can just like stomp it on the floor. Was that Demon Souls? Whatever. Now, if anything happens, you can protect me with that shield. All that, well, I don't know what to think of that, Zelda. You were obviously thinking about yourself when you picked the shield, but you gave it to me to use to protect you. So, that's interesting. Huh. Zelda, you are quite, forward-thinking there. Oh, I almost forgot. We have to take Master Smith's sword to the castle. That's highlighted in blue. Let's go, Foppy. Let's go. There we go. Yeah. I don't know what the hell I'm doing there. Hello, snot boy.
So, I've been good all year. Like all along. All year long. And you know how the Pikri, when they show themselves, they've been good? And so, I'm just waiting for Pikri to come play with me.
Okay, you're gonna be waiting a long time, kid. My sister and I came a long way to see the Pikri Festival this year. Is it true the festival's named after tiny people the size of my thumb? I guess. I mean, one kid said they saw him in his shoes. Hello again, airplane. God. Do you know where I can go to see them? No. What do you want, little girl? People from all over the place come to Hyrule. I'm not gonna read this. I'm gonna take a sip of water instead. I'm really thirsty. Or rather, my throat is just completely dead now. I've been dispatched from Hyrule Castle up north to watch over the festivities. Da-da-da-da-da. Come on, Foppy, let's hurry to the castle. You only wasted like fucking 15 minutes just doing some stupid shit down there. What's the sign say? I said, what did the sign say? Hyrule Castle, Hyrule Town, Mount Krennel, Lake Helia. Alright, well, I guess we're going up. Oh, look at this son of a bitch. How dare you hurt Princess Zelda? Ouch! That must be the business scrub I heard the soldiers talking about. They were saying a Deku scrub had been hassling all the passerby. Foppy, do something about it, otherwise we can't get to the castle. If only we had some way to defend ourselves against those nuts of his! Could just say no. Whoa, shit, I forgot which button I had the shield on. There you go.
Please forgive me, sir. I heard there was a festival and I came to town hoping to hawk my wares. Unfortunately, we scrubs have a tendency to spit nuts when we speak. Everyone got scared and ran away, and no one would buy anything. This is a terrible place to do business. I'm going back to my cave.
Yeah, you should go back to your cave. I gotta stop playing with the stylus. I apologize if you can hear that. It's like a little habit of mine. I actually feel a little sorry for that business scrub, but that nut hurt. Oh well, he won't be hassling anyone now. Better hurry to the castle. Let's go, Zelda. This time I will protect you if any nuts come flying at you. Give him a little and a That's right. Nothing can pass that defense. Hello. Welcome to Hyrule Castle. Hello.
Princess Zelda, when did you leave the castle?
You guys are terrible guards. That's the moral of this story. Ah, the sword for the award ceremony. You should take that to the minister. Potho? Potho. It's probably Potho. That makes a lot more sense than Potho. Makes it seem like he just lives on the toilet and just does nothing but just commandeers the toilet. Sorry, but we're getting things ready for the ceremony. I can't let you pass. Okay. Hello. Preparations for the award ceremony come along nicely. Cool. Are you gonna say the same thing as the other guy? Yes, you are. Not even for a cold 20 rupees, because I got that on me, man. I got that. But you don't want it. Hello, weird-shaped head guy.
Oh, Foppy, you brought the sword, did you? Then as minister to the Kingdom of Hyrule, I, Potho, accept this blade. You came just in time. The award ceremony will begin soon.
I'm sorry, Foppy, but I better go. I have to prepare for the ceremony. I had a good time at the festival. Thanks for coming with me.
Oh, you're welcome, Zelda.
Since you're here, Foppy, why don't you join us for the award ceremony?
Okay. It's not like I was doing anything, you know, I was just sleeping before I was rudely awoken and then demanded to come here.
Do you know about that sword, Foppy?
It is called the Pickery Blade, and it looks much evil away in that chest. The Pickery Blade is sacred among the people of Hyrule. The legend has it that long ago the Pickery gave us this blade. Whoever wins the competition earns the honor of touching the sacred blade. That's it? Holy shit, it's Wind Waker. Is his name Darkness as well? Let the award ceremony commence. Vati, champion of the competition, you may approach the blade. What is your name? What is your favorite color? Well, black, obviously. Kind of looks like Magus from Chrono Trigger, doesn't he? Did he just give the salesman's laugh, the mask salesman's laugh from Majora's Mask? I think he did. Wow, that's creepy. So what this leads me to believe is that the happy mask salesman in the Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask is a descendant or ancestor or in any way related to this crazy, very obviously evil dude. That would explain why the mask salesman likes to shake children, that asshole. To think it would go this well. The Pickery Blade and the Bound Chest spoken of in Hylian lore. This chest must hold that which I seek. I'll relieve you of its contents now. Oh! Well, that was a bad plan. Do not interfere with me. As victor, I've earned the right to approach the Pickery Blade. I've been waiting for this moment. Holy shit. Does that mean that if we fight him, we're just gonna have to, like, flip the spell back at him? Damn, he opened up that chest. Look at me with my shield. I'm like, this'll protect me. Who are you? Why are you doing this? Princess with the mystic aura. The power that was gifted to the people of Hyrule still flows within the veins of the ladies of its royal family. Interesting. If I leave you now, you'll only cause me trouble later. That will never do. To stone with you! That's right, you protect her. Oh man, you did a bad job. Foppy, you did a terrible job. All who stand in my way shall share this fate. Now to find out what power awaits me in this chest. It's empty, isn't it? Hmm? Empty? There was nothing in there but a rabble of monsters? What is the meaning of this? Well, I know the force I'm after is somewhere out there. I'm in no hurry, I can take my time searching for it. Well, time to go be evil elsewhere. Look at that evil warp. Freaking Magus looking motherfucker.